We just dive off and shake that tail like a helicopter. Not gonna work. We're gonna try to. Oh no! Hello, everyone. My name is Garrett Oakamber, and I'm just chatting with this guard. No particular reason whatsoever.
A lot happier with a belly full of need.
Okay, I believe. Okay, we're gonna commence our main story mission crawl, as we have deviated a little bit from it, just doing a few random quests. Playing around with this new weapon I got, and it's cool, but it's paling in comparison to the weapon we worked so hard to forge. So we're gonna switch to that for now. Maybe we could find some use for it later. If not, some of our companions will wield it. We already have one person using one of those swords, so that's very useful. We're gonna fast travel to the nearest location to Skyhaven that I have. Though I could take a, you know, basically a ride over.
Who dares?
Are you gonna even try this? Okay, well, now you're asking. Good dog. Random dog. Poor random dog. Of course, pick up one item. That dog is lucky. Oh, you're attacking me? I don't feel it. I don't mean to ruin your attempts at murdering me, but kind of shit. Visibility potion recipe. Thank you very much. I'm gonna drop some items. There's a war going on, and Garrett has to sift through his inventory. Don't need these. We have a lot of cloaks, that's our problem. We also have this ebony armor, which I'm not exactly using right now, but we should definitely give that to somebody at some point. Don't think we need these. No, not particularly. Okay, let's have that. Meanwhile, they're all practically dead anyway. Get in my way. Hey, you're already finished too. Cool. Okay, the battle has moved out over here. My fucking giant is leading the charge. This is not cool. I actually found a game that will be coming out, supposedly, before it's over. Quarter one. You know what? We might as well have a little bit of fun with this, right? Let's find, beast form. Kick some ass. Yeah, I found a game that I've wanted to exist for a long time. And there's going to be a game like it. So a while back, I was talking to a friend, and I was saying how cool it would be if Ark Survival Evolved actually had a medieval fantasy game. Like, so if you're familiar with Ark, it's an open-world survival game with dinosaurs. And the thing is, I always thought that'd be the coolest thing for, like, a game like Skyrim. The problem is that Elder Scrolls Online, which was promised to be like Skyrim, which was a fucking lie, was absolutely not Skyrim in any way, shape, or form. And I don't think the game should be like Skyrim. Ooh, I accidentally hit my other werewolf. Okay, that's good. Don't mind me. What the fuck are you doing? You just having a sit? What the hell is going on with you? Don't mind me while I just furiously roll at your crotch. I mean, this is something that a werewolf does, and I won't judge the werewolf. Not that I would. I mean, it's a bit gross. And I'm into women, not guys. But anyhow, where else has that mouth been? I mean, I've been eating all sorts of dead bodies. Why did I pick up force four arrows? They're awful. So the thing is, there is a fucking Hagrid. Oh my god. So the game is called Dark and Light, and it is basically a Unity. Not Unity, wow. Unreal Engine game that is fantasy-based. Apparently it's based off of another game called Dark and Light, which was not as successful, which was an MMO. So it's taking that whole open-world aspect to a whole new level, because it's a sandbox now. It's a sandbox MMO that can also be played single-player. I was actually admiring, for all the content that they're promising, the fact that it's available in so many different ways. Yeah. That poor Imperial, he has no fucking idea. Come here, you. Feed me. Feed me. So you have single player, multiplayer, you have multiplayer local, you have co-op, co-op local, multiplayer online, co-op online. That's crazy. That is an amazing amount of availability, I should say, is what you're getting out of the game. So if you have only one computer in your house, but you have a bunch of controllers, you can invite a bunch of your, you know, brothers and sisters, your friends, to come over and play with you on the computer. Oh, Sophia, I'm sorry. I kind of nailed it. Yeah, I saved you. It's okay. I did that. I see. I love you. It's fine. Yeah, she doesn't love me back. It's really sad. But the thing is that you're getting to play this game in all these different ways. And I was just marveling at the graphics and the abilities you have, I should say, to not only build, there's an entire magic system. Why is that activating? Don't do that to me. Thank you. Die, go. Me. Sorry. You remain young forever in my heart, in my mind. I sound a little bit like Sean Bean. Winter is coming. Actually, summer is coming, and I'm not happy about that, but I didn't even see that go. For that, it doesn't die. That was weird. So that's the cool thing, is that I found this game, I didn't even know it was going to exist, and it's exactly what I wanted out of Ark. I wanted them to make a spin-off game, which was all fantasy, and they're doing this, this other company is doing this with this game. We should probably turn back into human, because probably somebody won't be too pleased about a werewolf roaming the countryside. I can't imagine what it would be. There's a fucking mud crab, get out of here. Oh, okay. Oh, he's tickling you. That was cool. Hi, Lydia. How you doing? Yeah, I know. We gotta get a new companion. We have a serious sore spot missing since Uthgard died. Ghost is he's pulling his weight, though. He's doing a good job. I was really excited about this, though. This was such a cool concept for a game. One that I said, again, I've been waiting for the longest time and wasn't seeing anything come to fruition out of it. But, yeah, I didn't want to run by that guy and freak out and have my companions murder the shit out of him. There's a dragon nearby, I hear it. But yeah, Dark and Light. Dark and Light, it's called. And it looks so cool for what it is. The dragon. Is he actually going to fight us? I think he is. We're going to get out our Call of the Wild. Wolves. He's gonna have to find a place to... No, he's gonna sit there. Okay, that's fine. That's fine. I'm gonna get out my bow. Swamp dragon. Fuck. Is that steam you shot at me? Here I am talking about steam games. But yeah, if you get a chance, check out Dark and Light. It's gonna be a pretty cool game. I'm gonna shot you a little. I can fight you. Yeah, you're dead. Yeah, archery up. Angle level. So, those are my rules. Then, hey there, Swamp Dragon. Oh, you're pretty. Oh, no, you're dead. I'm sorry. I'm so, so sorry. It's cool. That's a cool dragon. Part of the Diverse Dragons mod. A little low res. Else, but it's pretty good. So yeah, Dark and Light, you're gonna be able to choose one of three different racial cities, elven, human, and, of course, dwarven. And that's so cool. You can customize your character in every way, shape, and form that you can imagine. I don't think many of our followers are going to be able to follow us through this, so we're just going to have to make do here. Hopefully they don't teleport on me and kill themselves on the rocks. That would really suck. Is the burial mound going to explode? Probably. Get out of the bow. As the main story progresses, you'll see Alduin opening up these burial mounds. He already came over here. Okay, so we got in range and the dragon was resurrected. Okay, that makes sense. We missed it. We weren't fast enough. Let's just admire the majesty that is Skyrim for a moment. Let's look at that. Beautiful, it is. Isn't that gorgeous?
Ooh, pretty color.
Like fucking ruins over there. And this little valley with nothing in it. Turn around, we got all these people eager to do whatever. I mean, they're all ready to kill, but none more so than Sophia there. She looks ready to fucking murder someone. That intent in her eyes. Just like,
I'm ready to go and murder things. Tell me, my lord.
Have me kill something, please!
Okay, so we have to figure out where we're going, and I think we're heading over here. But I'm excited, because I was only looking forward to Bannerlord and State of Decay 2, which there's still no information on State of Decay 2, and it's, okay, Lydia, what the fuck are you doing? Okay, you guys are all going where the fuck you want to go, that's fine. I mean, I'm not going to judge, but kind of confusing me. I was looking forward to Bannerlord, because I knew it was going to come out this year. Guys, Delphine is here. Hi.
What do you need, Dragonborn?
Wait, you're acting like I shouldn't even be here. You're not even... Okay.
Let's keep moving.
Okay. Oh, so now she's following me, apparently. Or not. I guess I can do this without... There's Esbern.
Are you sure this is the right way?
The entrance must be past the Forsworn camp.
It was a cold day.
I don't care. I really don't care. I think we were supposed to do the quest immediately, and now she's like... Oh, look! Friends! She's confused. My arrows do a lot of damage. You're gonna go get angry at me for some reason. How you doing? Yeah, so I'm just really excited because there's games that are coming out that I have a huge interest in. Ghost is gonna get shot in the back if he's not careful. I have a huge interest in them. I'm excited to see what happens, and I'm hoping there's gonna be a lot of people with the same interests. I definitely gotta tell my friend Ward about that because he's also very much into survival open world games. And since it's fantasy based and there's a magic system, there's a lot of room for, wow, a lot of fun. Damn, that's crazy shit going on. I think I could afford to get another mage. I mean, this kind of seems cool. I like this. I like having all these people. All these people to help me out. And I think more magic being thrown at the enemy would be just hilarious. Should I teach one of my mages, Tornado? Because that would be... I don't think it would be overpowered, considering how bad the game has been dicking. That's what I should do with that... Oop, well, I was going to pick that up, but whatever. That's what I should do with my vampire character. I should teach some people some holy...
Hey!
Hi! You, okay. Hi. I should teach them some crazy spells. I don't know what she was thinking. I mean, she was sitting there all by her lonesome, and then she decides to attack me last minute and gets killed. Hey, I gotta level up. Cool. Gonna increase my stamina a bit. This character is in a comfy spot. I have the power to take enemies out by myself, but on top of that, we also have, I have a lot of good armor. We have some really, 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 yeah, I'm gonna get this. Really good companions. Yep, okay, you all follow, all of you followers, all of you, just level the shit up. Don't let them shoot you, you're a fucking giant. Do something about it. Holy shit, look at Delphine. Fucking killed you. Delphine's just really pulling her weight. There's gonna be dragons, there's gonna be wyverns, there's gonna be all sorts of fantasy things. This is a really big fucking giant. Hi. He's been scaled up because of one of the mods we had, so that's kind of crazy to look at. Yeah, there's gonna be so many interesting things in this fantasy world, and you can still build, so it's very similar to Ark in that respect. Hopefully it runs a lot better, though, because I've been rather concerned. It's an ebony axe, I don't really give a shit about it. Probably nothing useful for us. You don't even know what you've just incurred the wrath of. You have absolutely no oh god, we shot her in the face. And it's gonna send your body downriver, it's fine. Weeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeee They become so rigid when they're paralyzed. I love it. I love it. Why not? Increase our smithing skill just a little bit. I think we could still stand to increase it. Just a bit. Actually, isn't our smithing 100? I don't know. Is it? Am I just being silly now? Smithing is 93. It's not 100. What happens... I'm curious now. What happens when I make a skill legendary? Can't do it with that. No, I can. What does legendary do? Making a skill legendary will set it to 15 and return its perks. Are you sure? What does that do? I have to find out. Okay, since I had never done it before, I just realized, the reason you have that option of making a skill legendary is to increase your level cap, because there is no true level cap in Skyrim. So what you end up doing is you keep resetting some of the skills that you use, attaining, you know, higher skill point levels in addition to that, because you're getting all those perk points again, and you can redistribute them everywhere. And if you keep using those skills enough, you'll be able to actually keep leveling forever. So that's it. Oh, you're a vampire's follower. Ooh, zombie. Hi. You're just gonna slowly walk away, Lilith. I don't know if you're aware, but your zombie is fucking worthless. So what we could do is at some point reset our melee skill, because we use our two-handed weapon a lot. If we get it to basically the max thing, we get to 100 and all that stuff, we could reset it again and start using the sword like crazy, and that would allow us... Where do we go? Oh, we go in here. Okay. That would allow us that option of continuously gaining levels. So eventually we will do that, I'm sure of it. It's not like we have a real need to do it, but it would be useful to some degree. You don't gain any other benefits other than... Oh, I can see your shadow. Hello. Other than more, Oops. We gain more levels as a result. That's about it. We get nothing else. Struggling to think here, because I'm so pumped now by that game I just heard of. Have you ever done that to yourself? You find a video game and you're like, oh my god, this is the greatest idea ever, and then you just forget about everything else in existence. It happens. It's happening to me right now. I'm excited. We're gonna drop those Forsworn arrows, because they are absolute trash. Where are they? Forsworn arrows, yes. Drop them. Really? You think you can contend with my group of heroes and villains?
Stay away from me!
This guy's like praying. Here, there you go. There you go, sir. There you go. You're good.
I hate it here.
Let's turn you around.
No one suspects the pillow sniffer. The pillow sniffer will come into your room at night and smell your pillow when you're not in there. You know those times you get up for a midnight snack? That pillow sniffer has been in your bed, and he's been sniffing your pillows.
It's actually quite a terrifying thought. What do you think, Mr. Ghost? Ghost Jarl Balgruuf, my friends. He is, not amused. So we're gonna continue. What? What was it? You looked like you were gonna say something. Meanwhile, Sophia was talking about werewolves in the back and the difference between werewolves and wolves. I didn't quite catch what she said because I was busy playing with the pillows. Oh, that's Delphine. That could have ended badly. Oh, goodness. This is a cool-looking dungeon, though. I forgot about this. It's been that long since I killed Alduin. I'm not even kidding. Like, I blew through the story missions as soon as I hit 30. As rule of thumb with any Elder Scroll game, you want to do all the important missions at 30 and make sure...
That's the one that appears to have a sort of arrow shape pointing down.
Contemplating old age, sir. Why is the world getting colder and your creases getting...
I wonder if I keep getting near you're gonna, like, fall over the edge. Let's try it. Esmer.
Esmer. I can feel your presence. Yeah.
No, he's not gonna do it. Okay. I thought he was gonna keep backing up till he went down there and breaks his shin bone, but rule of thumb, level 30 is where you want to start important stuff. So we have to figure out the puzzle. I don't actually remember the puzzle. I don't.
Yes, that's it. The symbol on the pillar on the left.
Whatever you did.
Oh. I was guessing. Okay, Esmeralda, fuck you. Lydia, you're breaking my heart. I didn't even know what I was supposed to do.
If these ruins frighten you, take comfort in the knowledge that I am here.
Shut up. Take comfort in the knowledge that I am here. So full of myself. Maybe I shouldn't have given him the gift of lycanthropy. Yeah, just run through the cobwebs like no sane person would ever do. I would freak my shit out. You have no idea. Do not. Oh, this is gonna be bad.
Be careful here. See these symbols on the floor?
This is gonna be bad. We have so many followers. Okay, who wants to take bets that somebody's gonna die here? I'm tempted to push you in, old man. Who wants to take bets that somebody will die here? Don't do the drinking game. You will lose this match. Okay. Okay, no one died. We took a direct hit from a fireball, but we're all good. We're good. We're all good. Okay, what the fuck is Delphine doing? Okay, Delphine. She's like, fuck this, I'm out. See, they put a lot of work into this. It's a small dungeon, but it feels so different than the rest of the game. I think what they're going to do is in the next Elder Scroll, there's going to be a lot of traps. A lot of traps and mystery. They hold your hand a little too much in this, more than Oblivion did, but I still feel clearly a trap. Still feel they did a fantastic job with this. Let's open it up. I'm not scared. Ooh. Curse. Oh, that's cheap. That is a cheap weapon. So basically, you're guaranteed to slay an enemy if that curse exceeds the target's health. That's crazy. I probably won't use something like that myself, but I'll put it on an item for my allies. I think I know what to do here.
Don't mind me, I'm Dragonborn!
Never mind. I was wrong. Oh no, I was supposed to...
You see how the ancient blades revered Cyrodiil?
I was probably supposed to shout at that. Whoops.
Alduin isn't getting any weaker while we stand around here.
No, he isn't. Oh, you just to cut your wrist. Okay, never mind. This is, So wait, what would happen if you're a werewolf or a vampire? Would it care about that, or would it be like, freaking out over it? Let's go in this very tight, narrow hallway that kind of looks like something ripped out of Morrowind, which isn't bad because I love Morrowind, but it reminds me a lot of Morrowind in here. It's got a similar color to it. There is actually a mod that changes the way this looks, but I chose against getting that because I don't know if it was going to fuck up my my entire thing here. I want to destroy my main quest. Okay. We got a wall here. Can I, like, poof? No? Wow. I thought my voice could do a lot more than that, but I was wrong. There's the hero-wielding power and the voice like thunder. There's the Oblivion Crisis Gate right there. Yeah. No, that's not the Dragonborn. Never mind, no. That's the Dragonborn right there. That's Alduin. But that's the Oblivion Crisis.
Huh?
Shut up. It's like, huh? We got some people here. I don't know who they are. I forgot the significance of that. That is Alduin. Yeah, these are the three heroes. Three heroes that use their voices. You can see it's coming out of their mouth like sputum. They use their voices to chain Alduin, but instead of chaining him, what it did was it pushed him into the future. Which is a big mistake. This is the Reign of Dragons.
rub for all the walking
here.
You made me do? What do you mean it's my fault?
I could have sworn there was something about Red Mountain, but I don't think... No, there's nothing in here about Red Mountain, unfortunately. That was a huge event, but... what we do have here...
Please tell me we don't have to listen to this guy giving a lecture.
Are these Aelids?
I'm already tired from all the walking.
Oh, something like that. Something
is
happening there.
Boring.
I know that's the Oblivion Crisis. That's something a lot of people missed out on, and that is supposed to represent what happened in Oblivion. That was the trigger for this happening 200 years later. Because if Alduin's brother, Akatosh, hadn't arrived, that would have never happened.
Yes?
But he did arrive. They're going to talk about all sorts of shit and be happy doing so.
Right,
we're going to give
you.
Lydia a torch, because I feel we have a serious lack of actual lights going on here, and... Sometimes it's a little dark. It's not the darkest it could be. Vanilla Skyrim is not that dark. But occasionally it's like it would help if we had somebody with a torch. You know? Maybe two torches. I don't know if you use individual stacks or what, but...
Divine smile on
you. Hey, sir, how you doing? Stop looking at me.
I am an apprentice wizard.
I know you're a wizard. You are a wizard, Harry Potter.
You are a wizard. We're going to give you... There you go. We gotta get you better armor, though. You get some really shitty armor. Probably give you actual armor or something like that, I don't know. Delphine?
What do you need, Dragonborn? The faction.
I really don't care about the elves, but I guess we have to find out.
When I was young.
Okay, she's still talking. I'm gonna talk to Esbern here.
Ah, of course. Not everyone has an appreciation for the artistic wonders.
Now, everyone has a competitive for that.
Okay, so she's going to hold a non-existent. She's going to do that. Ooh, you can do the robot dance. Do the robot dance. Come on, Delphine.
Damn it.
In the third part.
Delphine.
The prophecy.
Show me your secrets, young lady mistress. He's reading the story of the Dragonborn. Now, such a shit and the craziness and the stuff and...
That is... Oh, that isn't it. That's, what's his face? That, king from Oblivion that attacks you. That's part of the DLC. Knights of the Nine. We don't see nine souls, though. Maybe I'm just stupid. I don't know. Have you ever tried to play Skyrim in 20 FOV? Oh my god, he's frightening as shit. Okay, that's enough blowing chunks and making everyone ill. This is the part of the game where they lead you up for this epic area, and then they just basically promptly say, get the fuck out, we don't need you anymore. There's Akaviri armor and weapons in here, but it's kind of garbage. We could make them strong with our enchantments, no doubt. But, other than that, they're kind of trash. Some random pelts here. Black robes, you say? Ooh. Now, we're gonna give What's-His-Face actual armor. Hey, I got a torch back. Cool. I mean, don't mind me. I'm just robbing the ancient fucking chests that nobody's ever used. Why did I pick up glass? We're not making ourselves a house anytime soon. How are those bear pelts still good? How long has it been since anyone has been in here? I mean, I guess there's nothing to say that the people, the Forsworn that took this over, haven't been doing something with it, but even so, I'm kind of confused. Get some areas out here. Where does this go? Skyrim. Let's go out. It's been such a long time. It's very foreign to be in this place. And I don't have much memories of it because I didn't actually do the thing where you kill Parthenax. I liked Parthenax too much, and he didn't deserve to suffer. Oh, good thing I got out of there, right? Very good thing I got out of there. That could have been very bad for everyone inside. Well, just Delphine and what's his name. They probably wouldn't care. Like, the quest NPCs would be like, ah, you're a werewolf, cool! Okay. Let's turn. Let's do this whole thing. Damn thing. I have to forgive my English being a little bit lax today. That is a sheer cliff. Yeah, you join the party, man. You turn into a werewolf, too. That's why I gave it to you. Remember your master. We're gonna have a hard time getting out of here. I'm thinking We just dive off and shake that tail like a helicopter. Not gonna work. We're gonna try to. This is. No!
No! Sylvia! Sylvia! Oh no! Oh god! No! It's horrible! She just killed herself! Is she actually dead? I don't want her to die. I like her too much. Okay. She just killed herself. She just literally fucking killed herself. Is she dead? Sophia? Where? No. Sophia. She's alive! She's actually alive. Sophia, come back. Oh my god. Oh, that was horrifying. Sophia, baby.
Yes? Did you want something? Alright then.
Oh my goodness. See, everyone else uses the fucking slope, and she fucking just goes completely ham. We gained a soul from something, I'm not sure what. What is that? What's wrong with our tail? Oh, I just never noticed the underside of it. You'd think I would have at some point. I'm gonna turn off that tracking marker. She's alive, but... Oh my god. I've never seen the AI do that before. That was very unique.
Yeah, I've killed the cat that killed one of my hardcore characters. Look at this shit.
Okay, let's not just willy-nilly slap our claws around. We'll probably hit somebody and they'll leave us. Oh, I didn't... I'm sorry. I'll be a good puppy. I swear. I don't want to piss off more of my team members. We worked hard to get this group together. Uthgard kind of signed her own death warrant when she got fed up with our shenanigans. Anyone that travels with me should understand. I have an impish nature. I'm very, 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 very funny, silly, adorable, and cute. When you get to know me. When you don't, however, and you just take things for granted, I get very sad. I cry a little bit, you know, just a little. A little wee potato cry. I have heard potatoes cry before, don't tell me I haven't. There's a goat, we're gonna fucking kill it. Okay, got an altar here. So, no, I didn't click that, thank you very much. We have loot here, we could steal it. I don't think we're gonna want to steal it, though, because we could technically still get a bounty from that. There's nobody here to see, but I don't trust the game. I believe that we will get in trouble somehow, some way. Why is there ashes here? I've been here before? Yes, I have. These are the crabs. Okay, this is the same way we came. That's good to know. I'm gonna end this episode here. Thank you all so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed it. I know I talked about half of the episode, talked about another game that's coming out, Dark and Light, but I want to make it abundantly clear that I am very excited for it. That's me. As a YouTuber who plays games for YouTube, I really enjoy seeing games that I can get into. And I've been playing Skyrim because I really have been... Hardwin? Why do you have a unique name? Who the fuck are you? Is she a unique NPC? Are we gonna kill you and regret it? I don't know who Hardwin is. Sorry. You must die. Hardwin. Can I eat you? No, we can't, because she's fucking vanished. Cool. Awesome. I don't know if she had something important on her. She probably did, but it's gone now. Oh no, there she is. Ow! There's no fire. Fuck you. Who is Ardwin? Why are you still throwing fireballs at me? You fell more. Who is that? Who are you to think you can fucking kill me? You know what I am. Fucking monster. Yep, Stalmore. I join your friend. Okay. Get him, werewolves. More to my cause. Where the fuck did they go? That's Sophia. I really wish I could turn Sophia into a werewolf. That'd be nice. That'd be cool. Aye. Swim over here and enjoy your company. You ready? One-handed skill increase. Oh, that's cool. Okay, I didn't know that. That actually gives me... Ow. That gives me more of a reason to play as a werewolf, because it boosts that skill now. And I can't feed off that guy, because he's just playing Mr. Stiff as a board. Oh, it's Mrs. It's a woman. That's a female. Ah, lady, you are an ugly woman. My god. Okay. Thank you all so much for watching. I will see you all later in the next episode of Skyrim Special Edition Moonlight Tales. Bye.